Hello everyone, welcome back to Crypto Gains for another video. In this video, I thought we would talk about Ethereum. How many of you have actually seen the Ethereum website? This is probably one of the first times I've actually clicked on their website in a lot. Actually, no, to be fair, I think I saw it a while back. But they've updated it. Is that who I think it is? It looks like Vitalik, but like a mixed race version. Okay, one more laugh on that. Let's just do this. Before I dive into this video, I want to talk about things that I'm going to go over. So I want to talk a bit about the news. How high can Ethereum go? Let's also look at the staking side of things as well, because it's going to be interesting to see what kind of gains can be made. If it sounds interesting to you, please drop that like. Give me a subscribe if you're new watching. I will dive into this. But before I do so, I need to let you know I'm not a financial advisor. These are just my own personal opinions on the market. So please do your further research before you invest your money. That being said, the London upgrade has been released. We know this. That's the one where I'm talking about. Apparently it's supposed to, you know, deflate the coin, right? Because of the way the transactions are being done now. So, you know, supposed to apparently burn some tokens. I think. If I'm wrong and there's something else, let me know. But let's just have a look. So, you know, because I haven't seen the site like this in a while. So many coins are in the crypto space, and you don't get really take that time out to just look at the websites and stuff. It looks good though. I like it. You got some shit in there as well. Okay, let's just dive into this. Ethereum miners make multi-million dollar bet on upgrade delay. They think that the proof of stake is going to be delayed a bit longer, and miners are buying up more rigs to mine on proof of work. So let's just scroll down here. Hold on. Major mining machine makers like Bitmain and are building more specialized machines for Ethereum mining. Bitcoin BTC mining firms and miner manufacturers are increasing their investments in Ethereum mining despite the what happened? Did you see that? Despite the second network's impending switch to proof of stake, public Bitcoin mining companies Hut 8 and Hive are increasing their capacities to mine the second largest cryptocurrency by market cap. In the meantime, miner makers like Bitmain and Inner Silicon, I think that's right, are set to release new Ethereum mining machines later this year. Now, this is weird because I thought that in 5 months' time, you know, ETH was going to be going over to 2.0 for the staking. So if they're, you know, doing this late in the year, I guess it makes sense, 5 months. This investment may seem strange given that the Ethereum system, is anticipated to migrate from proof of work to proof of stake in about 5 months. And proof of stake mining does not require such advanced machines. So why are they doing this? Because they think it's going to be delayed. The rise in demand might be attributed to expectations that the migration will be delayed. If that happens, you're going to have a lot of upset people. Purely for the fact that people are investing a lot of money in Ethereum, hoping that they can start staking, right? And that's why I had to talk about this before we go onto the staking side of things. Because what kind of gains can be made? And then obviously we'll work out how high it can go, or how high it can realistically go, Ethereum. Which will also determine the kind of gains you can make when you stake. So right now, according to stakingrewards.com, they say that if you had, it's 5.72% interest that you receive annually if you was to stake Ethereum. Now, I don't know if that's if you need to have the 32 Ethereum. That's obviously if you want to be a validator. But I'm guessing any type of Ethereum that you have, if you're not a validator, that's the kind of percentage returns that you see back, right? And it's just showing 0.30 as an example here. If you had zero, let's just say one, because I would recommend, if anyone's going to get involved with staking Ethereum or having Ethereum as an investment, I would recommend going for at least one. And, you know, it's funny, because when I look back at, like, the past, because I remember back here, right, where was it, here? And it was like 60 quid a piece. I remember this because I remember just like, listen, back then, Ethereum would just filter through your hands because you didn't have what you have today. Like, when I think about Binance, funny enough, Binance has gone back to how it was back then because back here, you didn't have bank cards where you could withdraw your cash from Binance and stuff. You couldn't do that. Binance only did crypto. So, you know, you'd go onto one exchange, send it over to Binance so you can buy whatever coin you like and you know, send it back. You could never withdraw cash, or at least from what I remember. But what I'm trying to get at is that Ethereum back then, we was using Ethereum for everything. If we wanted to, because, you know, it was faster than Bitcoin, and the fees were not so high back then, and we were using it to transfer from, like, Coinbase to Binance, so we could buy this coin and that coin and that coin. And what I'm getting is, I had so much Ethereum filter through my hands, because you imagine, if you spend 600 quid, yeah, that's like 10 Ethereum. So if for every, like, or 670 quid was 10 Ethereum. And we were, you know, me and my mum, whoever that was investing in these other coins, were doing that. Because you, back then, 2018, XRP was an on Coinbase. So you had to go to Binance to buy it. So what I'm getting at is that, what am I getting at? I'm just trying to say that if you can, grab one. And maybe one might do you good for, you know, staking. Should Ethereum, I just don't know if it's ever going to happen. If something absolutely crazy happened and Ethereum dropped to 60 quid again, you best believe I'm selling everything. I don't care. My Switch is going. My PS5 is going. I'm selling. I'm buying as much as I can. Ethereum, if you did have one, 5.72%, you'd make over the each month. Over the, I was going to say over the, over the each month. Each month, you'd make $15 a month. Over the year, £188 a year. Sorry, dollars a year. That might not sound like a lot, but that's based on the price that we see today, which is 2,300, which is quite high, by the way. And look at the market cap. What kind of realistic market cap can we see? Well, I believe, me and myself, I got to say that, because if I don't, people be like, look, you said this, yeah? You said that Ethereum's going up, mate, and it's not, yeah? You just lied to me, man. Okay, I gotta stop. I think, just laugh at me, life's too short, that Bitcoin and Ethereum are really gonna hit these, you know, one to two. Well, Bitcoin would hit the 1 trillion. I think that they're both gonna sort of hit B around 2 to 3 trillion market cap. I honestly believe that. I really do. 2 to 3 trillion is what I'm calling. And if it is trillion at the max, and I don't know if it's this going to be this cycle or the next one. I'm hoping this cycle. Well, you know, if it is, what is 3 trillion? Let's have a look. That's 3 trillion right there. Let's divide Ethereum's market cap by the 3 trillion. Should it hit that? Because that's going to give us a rough estimate as to what kind of price we can see. Should it hit that? Now, I know it sounds like it's a lot, but please do not underestimate what's going on right now with Ethereum. The 2.0 upgrade is going to be insane. I can only imagine that large institutions are going to be grabbing these validator. Is it a class as a node? I don't know. But the staking side is really going to change the game for it. You're looking at a 10.8x gain. So you're basically getting 10.8 times your money back. 10.89, why not? Let's be precise. Essentially, you can take this here and then times Ethereum's price. So when you see a 3 trillion price for Ethereum, a 3 trillion market cap, essentially the price will go to times this by 2,000. Because that's what you're looking at, a £25,000 price for Ethereum. That's at a 3 trillion market cap. I believe that at the top of the, it can push it that high. That's the kind of prices that I'm looking at. Let's see what it looks like in dollars, because you're looking at almost $30,000, I'm sure. 25. And it might sound a bit absurd and crazy to some, but just don't outrule it, please. 25,619. You're looking at, whoa, you're looking at 35,000. Wow, man, I swear, US dollar, you guys have got to stop printing money, because I remember when 25,000 worth, or 25 quid was like $30, now your dollars, is it inflating, or hyperinflate? I don't know, it's just, all I know is I'm getting more dollars for my British pounds, that's what I'm getting at. $35,000 price, roughly, 35.4, just to be precise. So, yeah, those are the prices that I would look at in if I was to invest today in Ethereum to look at taking profits. Because at the end of the day, think of it like this. When you invest into the traditional stocks, right, the, you know, the Apples and the Netflix, they say, oh, you know, nice long-term investment, 5 to 10 years or 3 to 5 years. And over 3 to 5 years, you'll get your 5% interest. I'm laughing at that. But with, you know, crypto, you could just get that in a day. Matter of fact, this is up 0.6%. That's five times more what the bank than what your bank offers you. Oh, no, six times more because it's gone up 7. What I'm getting at is that this could, if you are going to invest in this, hold it to at least 5 years. Because in 2026, that's what we're talking, it could be sitting large. You just don't know. It could go higher than what I'm claiming. So just put it on your radar. So that I think that one might be enough. If you can afford more, than fine. Because, you know, if you can, if you've got the money and you can afford five of them, go for it, because it'd be five times this price. You're making 25 grand for one times five. If you had five of them, it's £128,000. I know people have got loads of this, and I wish I'd just bought... Actually, I wish I'd just kept them, not bought them, because I did buy it. I wish I'd just kept it back here when it's sitting at like 67 quid. I'm trying to find it. Where is it? I can't find it. Anyway, wherever it is. It's just mad when you look at things like that. You know, think about what you've got now. Think about the coins that you've got now, not just Ethereum. Any coin that you've got. And you go through a phase that looks like this. Right, you go through, let me just zoom this out a bit. You go through a phase that looks like this. And, you know, you're coming around here, you see it shoot up higher, and then it collapses on your face, and you're like, oh my god damn. Comes up again, you get excited. And then it collapses again, you're like, oh. And then you sell at these prices here, because people were selling. That's what this is. This is a sell-off. I feel sorry for people that are selling there. And then later on, you see that. It makes you wonder, with all the coins that we have, what's going to happen with them? Because if we're selling now, what prices are these going to be at in 5 years' time? Just makes you wonder. And I'm going to come back to this video if I can find it, because it could be buried alive, because I would have done more videos since then. But yeah, I think that staking that, you know, that would be a nice income. Because, you know, if that was the price of this, then you've got to times this also by 10 as well. So, because you got to, because the way I see it is the staking side would have, the price is increased, right? So you're not getting it based on this price of the 2,000. You'd then be getting it based on the 25,000. Should it hit a $3 trillion market cap? And at that point, this here, providing that's still 0.5.72, you'd be taking this price here and timesing that by 10.89, I think I said, didn't I? Let's just see if I can find it. Can't see it anywhere here, but I know it was 10.89. So let me just do this, because let's do $188. I know what it is. Hold on, $188 roughly. You times that by 10.89, you would be making every year. Should it go to $3 trillion market cap, you've got your one coin, you're happy with your one ETH, and you're staking. You know, that's your passive income. 2,047 a month. And if you had five ETH coins, I don't know, you're just putting it out there, times that by five, you'd be making 10,200 a year, which some people, that's like a part-time job or almost a full-time job. That's with five ETH. Some people might have five ETH. Some people might have 10 ETH, because if you have 10 ETH, what do? You times that by two again, because that's double again. You'd be making 20 grand a year. So, you know, the staking can be good, but you have to look at it on the long-term perspective, because right now, many average people don't just have £2,300 to just put in to get one coin. So that's the dilemma, because, you know, they look down and go, well, I might as well just get some Cardano because I get more for that, or I might just get some XRP because I get more for that. So yeah, I thought I'd share this with you. I find it interesting. This is interesting, the, you know, people buying miner rigs because they think that the mining's still going to go on. What's this freezing mining with Ice Age? Ethereum improvement proposal, the EIP 3554 introduced a difficulty bomb that adds artificial miners to increase mining difficulty, making mining operations less profitable. This period has been referred to as the Ice Age. Ethereum developers initially presented this EIP in 2015. And has been postponed to December 2021. Is this an old post? How old is this post? It says August 12th, so a couple of days. It's not that old. I guess he's just talking about what happened in the past. But yeah, I just find this story interesting that they're still buying because they think it's going to be delayed. Let's see what happens. What is interesting, though, is that if many people are gearing up for proof of stake, is proof of work still going to be happening? Because you've got ETH 2.0. And again, I'm just genuinely interested. Someone knows, drop some comments down below. Because if ETH is going to go into proof of stake, but proof of work is still happening, and the miners start to go over to the proof of stake, maybe there's going to be a lot more room for miners to make more on the ETH side. Do you know what I mean? I'm just trying to think about it, because many people won't be mining anymore. They would all go over to the staking, leaving the mining side open. I'm just thinking that's all. I don't know if it works like that. You let me know. But yeah, If this was helpful to you in some shape or form, please drop that like. Give me a subscribe if you're new watching. Thank you for watching. Big up to you all. I haven't really done much on Ethereum, but I think I need to keep my eyes on it because a lot's happening with it. And yeah, if you want to become a patron, I have 7 tiers. I see all the new patrons. I'm going to update my list today, and then hopefully by tomorrow or the next day, you will hear new names. It's probably just going to be added on the end of the last shout out, so just listen out for it. And yeah, become a patron. I have 7 tiers. Take your pick. I recommend, my buy sell stake alerts. Let's just scroll down. You can see different things, different prices, do different things. This one here, the exclusive VIP partner tier, this will unlock all my posts, my buy and my sell, my stake alerts. If you want to take that extra step, go for the CEO partner tier. This one's important. It's big because you can unlock my VIP Telegram group. You get exclusive access to that, where we discuss things way before I buy them or sell them or stake them or whatever we're doing. You best believe. We're buying things right now that you can't see. We're taking profit, nice, juicy profits on things right now. Well, patrons, you know now because you saw the alerts. But yeah, we talk about it in here. Maybe that little step is what you might need to get you just a step further so you're prepared. And there's 24-hour chat voice chats as well if you want to. Anyone can start a phone call and start a phone call. I sound like I'm from 1995. Just a little voice chat and we can all talk and laugh and, you know, share our ideas. But a lot of them just messaging there at the minute. We're seeing some good projects come up. And yeah, that's about it. So I'm going to shout out to my patrons. Are you ready for this long-ass list? Shout out to Ty Nottery, it's time 8. Actually, let me put my phone on silent, on play mode, because if I don't, people are going to be calling me. But let me do that again. Shout out to Ty Nottery, it's time for AJ, Frank C63, Clarence Dennison, getting it wrong. Clarence Dennington, Christopher Johnson, Jacob Adams, Mr. Anonymous, Stuart Chuckler, Carlos Rocha, Damaris, Samu Stancox, Rahul Degard. Listen, I got to do it quick because there's too many. Dante Kennedy, RG, Bizzle, Max, Wizard, Manny Sanchez, Tyrone Samuel, Abiola, Rachel Mack, Pamela Williams, Stacks on Racks, Rick, Joffrey Williamson, Omar Thomas, Cass Manel, Avan Davis, CCP269, Good Feels Nice, Dominique, Peter Stoddard, Eric Scoop King, Big Up, Semyon, Fatima Price, Shwanda Owens, Tanner McLaren, Josh Wills, Kevin Ward, Sassovi, Michael Keel, I think I said it right, Christopher Hoss, Chris Steed, Snowy, Andrea Harding, Kelvin, William Fox, Eshjar, Claudette Tormiliosa, like Wingardium Leviosa, float you up in the air, you best believe, Shakir Hussein, Lamar Lee Seeley, Cody Harris, S, Daniel Hopkins, Cyril, always get that one, you know what I mean, Alexander Forey, Gilbert Baggins, Eric Jackson, Paul Forrest, Power, Russell Cohan, Joseph Marcus, Crypto Mac, Crypto, hold on, give me the gains. Listen, I'm mixing it up. Mixing it all up. Villex, West A, M. Ali, Mo C, Fiat Justin, Mike V, J. Faye, Terry JC, Ollie, Orville Broomfield, NASA, Ignacio. That's a sick spell. Listen, I keep seeing Harry Potter spells in your names. I can't help it. G Crypto 117, Chris Chico, NM That Man, Francis Locco, Zach Adam, Mansour, Jean de Jaguar, Marcus Gittery, Exelios, flick that one at your hand, you best believe. I can just imagine Harry Potter. Exelios, mash up your head. Anyway, Stony Mac, what am I laughing for? John Lowe, Ranjo Singh, Raffle Krupa, Aiden, Ejiki Okori, just spin you up in the air, you know. Luke Ainsworth, I can see it. Mr. Durai, Anthony Berry, TRG Investments, Ryan Williams, Tukin, Santino, Crazy Gem, Timothy J. Brusky, Renee, UKMC, No Name, Pablo, Lena 111, I think that's right, Sunny V, Hani Abu, Ricardo Vinegas, Shinadu, Oscar Vilgas, Crypto Moon, New to You, Jackson Tepper, look, bang my chest, Francis Hernandez, Akbar, Jermaine Allen, David Adedigi, Chiquita, look, a lot of tongue twists, John Sandoval, Optimus Poompage, Edgar Cortez, Ramil TV, Kirsten, hello, Mr. Drew, SNCCC, Marlene Daddy Albers, Joshua Asher, Black Ape, Bob Rust, spit on my whole mic, you best believe, losing my breath, Eli, Mikey, UserX2019, Blackstar, Chiles Creations, Akis Voldorus, mash up your ear, what am I laughing for, Abid Hussein, Moses D. Lopez, Michael, I can't help it. Joseph Samara, I'm going to get a headache after this. Joseph Samara, Neola London, Chris Tap Dance. Oh, Tap Dance with you, best believe. Iris, Montreal Ammon, Joey J, Raj T, Brian Reedy, Terry, Cornel Goodman, Matthew Walker, Sarpinch Singh, Dennis Boonman, Mark Peak, Elliot Chill, Royal ID, Hassan P, Makuga. I think I said that right. Monica Matteo, Adam. No, I've got to start scrolling up again. Where am I? Monica Macho, Adam Allen, Ralph Green, Marcus Dunbar, Johnny Matthews, Artard, Moises Gallery, Mrs. Carla V. What's going on? Rizwan, Akins, Ice Cat, get it out again. Ice Cat Trader, Connie, Williamson Johnson, Anthony Donne, Carrick. You've never heard a list this long! shouting out people's names, sitting here for like 5-10 minutes. Karen Danick. I appreciate you though. It's just so long, isn't it? Are you still here? Drop a like. Kimberly Gearman. All for one. And one for all. Cylinder Toshima. Stefan. PC World. Who used to watch that advert? I used to love that advert. Marky 27. Dave. Chris Adlam. Crypto. Like, I got to have fun with it. Crypto Newbie. Thomas Rodriguez. Golden Bags. Noel 21. Jude Tam. Thierry. I think that's right. Joe Youssef. Arif Joy. Danny Rich. Elstein. Carnivore 444. Morgan Kovar. Job. Kilpashkumar. Alexis Pagan. I think I said that right. Sirafex. Kevin V, Crypto Hustle, big up. Nova, Muhammad Imran, Ankus Jane, Corey, Mario L, Vanessa Small, Elijah Alandy, I think that's right. Moinu Hussain, Nadine Jordan, Eddie Laform, D Wheels, Riyad Midikasu, Hashmatala, I keep thinking of Madagascar. Anyway, Hashmatala, Suraj Rashid, I'm getting there. Eamon D. Whaler, I'm halfway, I promise you. Max Sixel, Master J, Daniel Brown, Leon Plas, DG Crypto, I promise you, it's so long. Adam Isvan, Theodore Wheaton, LD Vincent Millett, Mauricio, Anoop N, Aman Rizvi, Janetta, Legend Charles Knight, Asa Jones, Duns River, Carrie, Gilbo Blaggins, Jake Ross, Cookie Crumbs, Cookie, I love it. Christian Lee, Philip Staffer, Fund Me Now, I will sort you out, don't worry. Crypt Dive, Maha Ramadan, I think that's right. Ramadan, yeah. Fiaz Ahead, Jim, Harsha, Bent Henson, I think that's right. Daniel Grigrio, listen, if I get your names wrong, just let me know, drop the comments. Idle Piper in the Patreon. Shark Tease, I'm getting your name mixed up. Sherry Tisosti? Sherry T. Zostek. There you go. Deshanovation, Mustafa, Skylark! Hold tight, DJ Skylark. I'm in the place of the DJ Skylark. I scroll up my screen with the DJ Skylark, you best believe. I love it. Because she's a DJ, right? Liz Reed, the A-Team, / something else. Jacob Medaris, Dave Catho, Richard Harmer, big up to you. Kyle Dawson, JP Deline, I think Deline. Let me know. Joey Shawns, Akeem Banks, listen, there's so many. Michelle Van Den Acker, what's going on, my lovely? Rosemary Hansen, Justin Levin, Via Financial, because you need to remember, save, yeah. Raycorn, Mr. Pauniti, Massey, Tonye Adekibi, I think I said that right. Seer Coins, Kasha Smith, Soul Seeker, I'm almost at the top of my screen again. Theodis, Paulo Baptista, Renton Bacco, Inigo Zibieri? Listen, I ain't done this in a while. Stefan Grunfield, I think that's right. RGC Visual, Lee Goodwin, Matthew Wan, Tristan Miles, John Hong, Saif Rama, May Revelle, I think that's right. Laurie Littra, I'm getting there. Alicia Abigus, what's going on? Nima Wambagu, I think that's right. Dez, David Lang, Saita, what's going on? Danny Ruddick. Kenny Broker, I think I'm getting there. Aaron Nguyen, Nick Smith. There's so many. Are you still here watching? I'm scrolling down again. And where am I? Naza, James Snowden. That's second of math. P Pie. It's got three eyes. Mr. Bonds, double starred. Mustak Dean, Michael Knight, S Terrell. Look, my eyes are watering now. Nate, Robert, John Carty, Josh Davis, Batch 1, VJ Kumar, you promise you've never seen a name called this long list. I can't even get it out. Fuchs, I think that's right. Devastator X, big up to you. Francis B, Christopher Hamilton, you related to what's-his-face Hamilton, the driver. Mr. Investor, Irina Lorenzo, I think that's right. Mark Raffle Stepnikowski, yep. Jordan Rutty, Gene Gerard. Gaspar Pestotnik. I think I'm Dr. Robotnik. I love it. Randall Jarrows. I'm almost there. Scythe. Matthew Kirk. Peter Butler. Scythe Muhith. I think that's right. Martin Wahenko. Big up to you, brother. Hold on. Is it Armin? Amin? I want to say Armin. Let me know. Jack Attack. Mirajus Shepherd. Jamar Richard So. Valentin. Work Hard. Play Hard. Sean Angus. Mr. Crypto Noob. Theodos Jansen. Cosmic Momos. Block Number 21. Adrian Kazonyi. I think that's right. Ken Zepeda. Or Zepeda? Let me know. I think it's Zepeda. Aidan Matthew and Andrea Evans. Thank you so, so much. My God, this list is getting longer. Just trying to scroll up now. You know, let me get to the top. Thank you all for becoming a Patreon. Truly appreciate you all. Wow! And I look forward to seeing you all in my next video. Cheers!